Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Chairman Bernanke, for your service. I want to speak to you about interest rate manipulations by large banks since the Fed plays a key role in ensuring the integrity of interest rates that affect consumers, small businesses, and cities and towns across the country. You know, I look at these most recent set of allegations on the LIBOR manipulation, and once again it exposes to me a culture of greed, a culture of cheating, of lying, at least at one large bank, and probably many more, which is why 9 of my colleagues and I wrote to you and other banking regulators and the Department of Justice last week asking for a robust investigation in the role of these banks and how this ultimately affected consumers in this country, investors in this country, cities in this country, because LIBOR is it's far more than a benchmark. It's a very significant indicator here that's used. I know that the Federal Reserve Bank of Cleveland found that 45% of prime adjustable rate mortgages are indexed to LIBOR. 80% of the subprime ARMs use LIBOR as a benchmark. So this is a huge issue, and it again goes to the integrity of our financial system and the lack of faith, I think, increasingly that the American public, and for that fact, many of us, are having in a system. I look at the internal emails during 2005 and 2007 of Barclays derivative traders asking other employees to submit false survey responses in order to benefit their trading positions, changing them, preferring certain LIBOR outcomes on certain days, sometimes for it to be higher, sometimes for it to be lower, depending upon how it would benefit their position. Now, I look at this and I say to myself, this is about trying to manipulate a key economic indicator for the purposes of profit. Am I wrong on that?
No, I agree absolutely. This is unacceptable behavior.
Well, let me ask you, clearly then banks like Barclays were trying to profit from the LIBOR manipulation, but that profit came not at the expense of the public in general.
Some of the public. It's actually an interesting question. You mentioned borrowers. Borrowers may have benefited because LIBOR was underreported. We'll probably find out via a number of lawsuits that have been filed and investigations.
But if you got caught in that period of time in which the traders wanted the higher LIBOR, and that was a time in which your adjustment was going on, you had a detriment to yourself. Yeah. Investors obviously had a detriment in not knowing the integrity of the institutions, not knowing LIBOR. If it's lower, it means things are working pretty well. When it goes higher, it's sort of like a warning sign, is it not?
I'm not defending it. I think it's a major problem for our financial system and for the confidence in the financial system, and we need to address it.
Well, so how do we address it? For example, I know that some of my colleagues here bristle at regulation, but it seems that this is an industry that on its own won't work with the integrity that the public deserves. I mean, we're talking about pension fund investments, mutual fund investments, investments by regular investors, as well as the consequences to consumers. I'm sure that we're talking about billions in effect, if not trillions in effect. So, for example, do you think that we need additional internal controls or firewalls between reporting personnel and trading employees at these banks, so that we don't have this work to manipulate? As one example of, I'd like to hear, what is it that we are going to do now that we know all of this and may have known it before? What are we going to do to ensure the integrity of this banking system?
Well, first, it's going to have to be an international effort because this is a British, LIBOR is constructed by this UK organization, and of course, LIBOR is constructed for about 10 different currencies as well. So it has to be an international effort. I think there's broadly two approaches. One would be to fix LIBOR, to make changes to it, to increase the visibility, to reduce the ability of individual banks or traders to affect the overall LIBOR and to increase monitoring of the reporting process that is done. So that'd be one strategy. The other strategy, which many people are thinking about, is going from what is essentially a reported rate to a observable market rate as the index, and there are a number of possible candidates that have been advanced that might ultimately replace LIBOR. As you point out, though, LIBOR is very deeply ingrained in many contracts, and so that change will be not a simple one to make. But I agree with you that we need to address this problem.
Well, I'd look forward to the Fed's leadership in this regard, the suggestions of how we, in fact, make a system that cannot be manipulated, that has consequences to millions of consumers, investors, pension funds, municipalities, counties, governments, all affected by LIBOR. And so it may be an international response that we need, but we need to understand what we can do here in the United States to ensure for these investors and these consumers.